it has been almost a year since we started looking to have a permanent place of our own in Tennessee. So I thought I would go ahead and just create a video to document a little bit of my husband's and my journey to getting our own place in Tennessee. It's now the third week of November 2021, and it has been almost a year since we started looking to have a permanent place of our own in Tennessee. Some of you may know that my daughter, son-in-law, and grandbabies live there, and with my family kind of having been spread in different places, I was in California basically by myself after my son moved out in December of 2020 to go to Phoenix. And so I came to Indiana to spend time with my parents here while Garth and I tried to continue to work out getting a home for ourselves in Tennessee. My husband had actually found a piece of land that he really liked, and there have just been so many numerous problems with trying to get approval for septic, and having lived in California in the beach cities my whole life, the concept of even having to get septic or making sure you have sewer, you have septic, you have running water, you have, you know, a well, whatever you have. It's just at home, it's easy. You walk in your apartment or your home, you turn on the water, you turn on the lights, you've got your electricity, you know, everything is easy. We are still dealing with a piece of property that we wanted to buy that we wanted to have septic on, and the state is still saying there's not a possibility to put that on very easily, and the person we had been working with now no longer works in the company. In the meantime, we finally decided we need to look for something else, and we had put in an offer in September on a fourplex. Actually, it was actually just a four-unit apartment building, two separate buildings, but the agent who'd been helping us try to find something asked us if we'd be interested in that, and so we were, and we put in the offer based on the price that we had been told. The seller had countered for just a small amount more, and we all signed the documents, and then the next day I guess she freaked out thinking she didn't sell it for as much as she needed to. She'd put in a lot of money into improving it, I guess, and didn't want to sell at that point, so we just let that one go. And then I was getting frustrated again. Why is it taking us so long to find something that is ideal for us? But anyway, we finally found a house that we put in an offer. We were supposed to have closed November 4th at the latest, but it was looking like it probably would have been October until another glitch came up. And so finally, now today, we got notice that we should be closing the day before Thanksgiving, and we'll finally have a home that we can make our own. Of course, it's going to need some fixing up and things, but I'm excited. I will have a place. It will be the first house that Garth and I have ever owned together, and I will be in the same town where my grandkids are living and some extended family on my daughter's side. I am less than a day's drive away from my parents or my mother-in-law. We're kind of in the middle of both, so I'll be able to, you know, drive either to Indiana or Alabama as well and see them. I'm finally getting excited that it's so close to the end. It's been a very long journey this last year, and I'm looking forward to learning all kinds of things that I've not even really done before, whether that's actually having a really nice garden, potentially learning how to can some of the things that we grow, learning what it's like to live in snow, drive in snow, be in cold weather that's really, really cold, not just what I say is cold in California in the beach towns. So I am going to document over time just some of the things that I'm doing and learning. And I was that city girl not knowing a lot of the things that people, you know, do around here, just kind of typical. So I'm excited to see kind of what happens over the years. And I'll just document my journey as we go along and see how I do. But anyway, I just thought I would start with being thankful that we finally are going to have the place that, I guess, we just had to go through these challenges just to wait for this place to come up. And it's got a beautiful view. There's room for my grandsons to run around in the yard. Two trees right out front that I already can picture having a tree house in there. I'm going to have my work from home office that I can, you know, set up, have an extra little room for my grandsons, to have them come over at some point. We've got family coming to visit, but I'm excited to actually have something that I can make my own and learn what it's like to decorate. I've never even really had the chance to truly decorate something and make it home, so this is going to be exciting. And I hope you join me for the journey.